And welcome back to this deadly game, this deadly despair, this Danganronpa 2.
I decided to actually say the name correctly. Hey, look, Dürrlaminen case is open. Yeah, I believe he said it was made of Dürrlaminen. Awesome, thought it was closed, but there are a lot of odd-looking things in there, like a nightstick and pepper spray. What's this? A hard plastic case, but it's a case and the inside is empty. Wonder what was in there. But the one thing that really catches my attention is the small key. It must be the key to open the other Dürrlaminen case. That the other case was in the office and all of the collected injured items were inside of it. The key to that Dürrlaminen case is right here, and it's unlikely the mirror weapon used to kill Byakko was taken from that case. Which means often is inside that Dürrlaminen case aren't related to the Byakko's murder. I don't get it. Why does Byakko have this Dürrlaminen case filled with stuff in it? A case packed with all this security equipment. Maybe he was being extra cautious in case? No, they can't be right. That's way too overboard. He must have known something was going to happen. And because of that, he went all the trouble to be extra careful. Or he was planning to kill someone because he's an asshole. Let's take a look at this body. There he is. Dead Byakko, yeah. Let's investigate the top of the table. Though the only thing on top of the table catches my eye is a desk lamp. Looks like an antique lamp and it seems rather heavy. Power cord was connected to the outlet, so it would have been useless during the blackout. Other than that, there's nothing else on the table that really stands out to me, so now's not the time for me to flinch. I gotta do it.
Let out a shout, as if encouraging myself, and quickly look beneath the table.
Hey, look, a dead body. Hey, look, it's the smell of blood. Hey, look, there's ham hands. But he tried his best, and now he's dead. And now he's dead. And now he's dead. And now he's dead.
Let me investigate.
Huh? What is this? It looks like binoculars, but why is there a pair of binoculars under the table?
Hey.
Actually, those aren't binoculars. They're night vision goggles, you fucking idiot. Yeah, they're on the island. Remember? Oh, yeah. In that case, the killer used the night vision goggles to kill Byakko during the blackout. Yep. Right, what's up with the tape? I'm stuck to the back of the table. Is that duct tape? Seems to be paint applied to the non-sticky side of the duct tape. Dim light beneath the table seems to glow on the dolly. Could this be glowing paint? And it's also on the knife. Blood knife. Is this the weapon used that killed Byakko? Hold on. How did the killer bring this knife in the dining hall in the first place? Byakko thoroughly patted down everyone and thoroughly inspected every corner of the old building. And all the confiscated dangerous items are supposed to be placed in that Dürrlaminen case. Possible they stole the knife from the case, or they hid it somewhere hard to find. Also, there's one more thing on the knife that's strange. The paint. It glows. It's the glowing paint. It was taped to the table. Whoa. Pretty obvious. Let's take a look at the body. Face down under the table. As if he was in the middle of attempting something, it looks like he was. According to the Monokuma file, he was repeatedly stabbed between the throat and the abdominal region. Repeatedly stabbed. Would one of us really do something so horrible? Also, this jam! Fuck yeah! Let's just listen to this for a second. So good. So good. Right, am I missing anything? His hand. Okay, we already read this one. Maybe the blood stain? Yeah, there we go. Blood is flowing from Miyake's body, formed a huge pool under the table. That's a lot of blood! Even the inner side of the tabletop is covered in blood. Blood might have splattered all over the place when he got stabbed. But there doesn't seem to be any drag marks leading from the blood pool. So he was there. He was not pulled under there, he was there. I'm pretty sure I've investigated everything under that table. But the fact it's just me, I think I'm working pretty hard. Alright, we're getting some, we're getting there. Food. We already looked at the case. Table. Something I want to run by you. Before the blackout occurred, Byakko was in the dining hall with the rest of us, right? Yep. And if Byakko's dead body was discovered after the blackout, Then don't you think he died during the blackout?
Yep.
But...
well, why was Bianca's body under a table? Even if the killer tried to hide him, it's not like he would have stayed hidden forever. Isn't it confusing? You're absolutely right. Seems finding out exactly what happened during the blackout is key to solving the mystery. No way I'd know, it was so dark during the blackout, I couldn't see a
thing.
That's
not it.
Although if seeing is was impossible, then there's a possibility someone might have heard something. That's true. Yeah. Where's musician chick? Alright, let's run by, you know, everything with everybody else real quick before we go. You alright? Yeah, I'm fine.
What's going on?
Is that what you expect me to say? Because I feel terrible! I mean, Bianca is alive and well, and instant, something awful suddenly happens. Of course I'm not fine.
Why?
Not only that, but whoever killed him is an asshole. Yeah, it hasn't been determined, but you're right. Yeah. Yeah.
This is the worst.
You're right. Somebody killed him. I don't like it either, but we won't survive if we don't go through with it. Not just for yourself. We have to do it to protect all of us. If I only act calm during the situation, Bianca might still be alive. The whole thing would have never happened. Don't blame yourself. It's not your fault. Alright. We ain't doing this. Forget what I just said. I ain't being a bitch no more. And, in fact, you stop being a bitch, too. Fucking goddamn Hajime, you goddamn stupid little bitch. Also, you remember those photos? Say cheese. Want to see them? I have a digital camera so I can show them right now. Yes, please. See it. This photo. And this one. Something wrong? Didn't realize it until now, but right before the blackout, Bianca was standing in a totally different place from where we found him. Wasn't his body under the table's lamp on top of that, the one underneath the monitor? Prior to that, Bianca was standing along the wall farthest away from that table. Right, that's pretty far. There's something. Everyone's standing position before the blackout might be a clue. Can you approximate everybody's standing position from these photos? Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. It'd be hard to understand the photos from the photos alone, so it might be better for me to plot it out. Would that actually provide a clue? I don't know yet, but I feel like it could.
Leave it to me.
Got it, then leave it to me. That's pretty much the only job I could do anyway. Thank you. You're being helpful. I appreciate it. And now? Alright, now that that's decided, you better work hard, you motherfucker. Don't be a bitch, you goddamn cocksucking
second
little bitch. I will fucking stab you! Oh. Alright. How's it going? I must investigate my classmate's body. Yes, I'm the only one with medical knowledge. That's why I needed to do it somehow. Before you start, why don't you calm down a bit? I'm careless enough as it is. That's pretty obvious from how you felt earlier. I'm terribly sorry about that for showing you something so unsightly. You made me remember it again. Yes, I did. You're making a fool of yourself. How in the world did you do that? I got started by the blackout, slipped on the carpet, and once I was struggling to get back up... It's so embarrassing. Please, please erase it from your memory. Even if you ask me, I won't be able to do that easily. Sorry. I can't stand it. Why? Right. What are your four Dark Diva scents?
Impossible!
Is the effort futile as well? You looking for that earring you dropped?
You!
It's not a mere earring, it's a hellhound earring.
Fine.
Long ago, in a faraway land, a beast known as the hellhound was feared by all, even by he who summoned it. Alright. The hellhound tore its way through the innumerable battlefields, its flanks glistening with blood, and its drenched blood-red fur would dry in the howling winds of loneliness. When it finally tamed that diabolic beast, I received an earring to commemorate that event.
Shiver!
The Hellhound earring. So that I may never forget the night I battled that fearsome Pomeranian. I will wear that earring at all times. It was a Pomeranian? Alright.
I won't let you!
Where did it disappear to? Maybe it fell underneath the floor. Copper didn't cover the whole floor. It might have fallen through the gaps between the exposed floorboards. Well, that's what's inspired. Such a clever little bauble. Alright.
I can see it!
I have found it, truly that is the Hellhound earring! It seems God exists for my benefit! I see, good for you.
Let me ask.
However, how do I recover? Connecting my arm through this opening, where do I... Were I to use a tool, I would probably not reach the either. And maybe it's just give up.
What?
Give up? What? The world? I might give up the earring.
You!
Have you not realized? It will come to an end if the human race were to lose that earring. You humans, so satisfied with clothing yourselves in layers of false knowledge.
You flinch, you will die.
But even with all those layers, you still will not survive the winter. Okay. It was foolish for me to rely on you fools. Fine, I shall do something about it on my own. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must go save the world. Okay. Okay. I believe that's everything. What? What am I missing? Talk to everyone. Yep. Pepper spray, empty case. Maybe I need to realize that's where the night goggles came from? I don't know. Talk to her again. Yeah, please forget about it. Okay. Byakuya, you have anything else for me?
Perhaps.
Yes, her, but I need to go leave to talk to her. What do I need to investigate? What am I missing? AC remote control? Air conditioner, could it be? Hey, I love you. Why can't you act like more grown up? What was I saying just now? Yep. The AC. It probably broke it. Ah, it was you, AC timer. The AC provided a blackout. A moment. What's up? When we're finished with the investigation here, would you like to hear what everyone else has to say together? If I go by myself, some people might not talk to me out of caution. Well, we've been told that one of us is a killer. Can't be helped if everyone's on edge right now. Why me? Because you're easy to talk to, and I like you. We both harbor a special feeling towards Hope's Peak Academy, isn't that right? Well, yeah, but... fine, if we're going together, let's go on with it. There's no time for idle chit-chat. Sweet! And so, what he said about being similar, I can't help but agree.
Yeah.
Well now, let's go search inside this building. Like everywhere. Like everywhere is a crime scene. You are first.
I see.
Apparently, a great man once said investigations should be done on foot. So that's why I'm also using my feet. I'm just walking around for no particular reason. Okay.
Hey.
Hey, I just realized something. Could she, by any chance, know what happened during the blackout? I was thinking the same thing.
Are you serious?
Huh? How'd you know? So you did hear us, even though Hachiman and I were talking pretty softly just now. Not only do I have a perfect face, style, and personality, but I also have perfect ears. See, your hearing is so good, maybe you heard what actually happened during the blackout. Did you hear everybody's voice throughout the dining hall, right? We couldn't tell, but you would have been able to make out who's who, right? Just leave it to Ibuki. It'll be easy as fried rice with gravy. La 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 la. I'll hardly eat it for breakfast.
I see.
Oh. I think it means it'll be easy as pie, except eating fried rice gravy for breakfast is kind of heavy. Any fried rice that isn't fried rice gravy is so wrong. Alright. Anyway, can you tell us what you heard?
I've got it!
Leave it to me, I'm gonna take a bite out of you.
Yep.
If you tell us, I'll let you take a bite out of Hajime later. No!
Aww.
Let's see. First person to raise their voice during the blackout was... alright, that's right, it was Mahiru. Next was Kazuichi's voice, and then next was mine.
Hey, I can't see anything!
It's pitch black! My future is pitch black!
Yahahaha, what a nice remark I made. This is to the point and has its own unique charm. Keep going. and more voices, one after the other.
Everyone, calm down! Ah, don't step on my bee!
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
Turn the damn lights on! I can't eat like this, you know!
You guys? Where are you? Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
Perhaps the breaker overloaded?
Hold on a sec. I'll go along the wall and do something about it.
Alrighties, that's pretty much it. Aren't I awesome? Praise me, praise me. Give me a lot of praise. I heard you the first time. Don't get any closer. Not gonna do. Say something to her. Hey, did something happen? No, I was just thinking about what Byakuya said during the blackout. Byakuya said, why did he say something like that? Rather, why was he able to say that? What the hell? What's going on here? And this is... What do you mean? About that, why don't we discuss it after we've investigated a little bit more? And now I can't really say anything for certain. Okay.
Yep.
Anyway, don't you think Ibuki's scout just now is an important clue that will lead us to the truth?
Yahoo!
And praise me, let me bite ya! Ow, what the fuck? Why are you biting me? Get me out of here! Why are you here? Sonya, never mind. Alright, let's check out the kitchen. We'll ask her in a bit. Talk to Terra. Hey, were you in the kitchen during the blackout, Terra? Yeah, it spooked me. At first, I thought it was just in here in the kitchen, but when I finally managed to get out of the kitchen, I always pitched black too. Then I heard everybody's voices, so I fumbled along the walls to try to get my way to the dining hall. But that place was pitch black too. It was like pitch black everywhere. And you have used that kitchen stove as a light?
No.
Ah, that's impossible. The gas stove needs electricity to work, so it was directly affected by the blackout. I see. Okay. Since you work with fire in the kitchen, I figured you'd be able to use something as a light source or something, but it's not that easy. Good to know. Okay, food. It's an amazing, the meat is so big, even I was shocked. Guess it was a dish fit for a tropical island. I'd never be able to get meat like this in Aoyama or Aizabu. I'd never be able to get meat like this in my hometown, much less Aoyama or Aizabu. I get it, you don't have to repeat yourself. But it's so big, where'd you get it? I asked Nekomaru. Apparently, he killed the cow at the ranch with his bare hands and brought it over. What the fuck? Okay. Good to know. Alright.
Man.
Well, I guess this meat has gone to waste since the awfulness has happened right when the party started. Only ones who ate any food were Akane and Peko, who took portions for herself.
Eh?
Don't say that. After I worked so hard to cook the world's most refined party dishes, only two people actually tasted them.
Tell you the truth.
Also, like, I actually believe it, but if there really is a killer out there, I'll probably never be able to forgive that killer. Indeed. You know, Peko Peko could have taken a knife. Or an iron skewer, whatever. What? From outside.
That's weird.
Strange, isn't it? I mean, he didn't go easy on the girls he was performing on the pat downs. Weird.
Hey.
Okay. Yeah.
You're right.
That makes sense. Everything's covered. Alright. How you doing, Sonya? There's something I want to ask you. What is it?
It is strange.
Because that only that wall is a different color than the material.
Perhaps.
Why is that? That was probably a fire door. Fire door? You never seen one before? It's a door that shuts to keep fire from spreading by containing it. If that happens, you can run away, right?
Wow!
I see! It's just like a barrier, just like lining up plastic bottles around the house. That's only done to keep cats from getting in. You know about keeping cats from getting inside, but you don't know about fire doors.
I am ashamed!
Truly, I'm culturally ignorant. I am ashamed of myself. Okay. You can't use them. Ibuki. Toilet. Don't see Peko Peko anywhere. Alright, let's go check the storage room just in case there's any clues in there. And what do you do, Nagato? How come Miyako was able to say something like that in the darkness? Like, what the hell? What's going on here? Or, this is. Makes me wonder. Yeah, he must have had those goggles on, huh? I mean, he must have been able to see. Really dusty and dark in here. I couldn't clean in here, so you know. Anything in here? We don't have time to go through each and every one of them. Okay. What about this? There's a huge piece of cloth randomly shoved in here. Is this a tablecloth? Oh, a tablecloth. Wait, huh? Hold on, there's something on it. Is this a bloodstain? Huh? A bloodstain? Come here, take a look. Close look. It's too dark, can't really see it in there, clearly. There's no mistaking, it's clearly blood. Which means the tablecloth is connected to Byakuya's murder, right? A tablecloth has a bloodstain, I don't think it's a possibility. Seriously, it is a bloodstain. Alright. I think I'm starting to piece things together. Is this for anything? Looks like they were recently turned on, but why? I thought your eyes were missing a thing. When I was looking for Byakuya after the blackout, I found these irons, but when I found them, all three of them were turned on.
Yep.
It'd be bad if another blackout happened, so I turn them off. But it doesn't this feel kind of sinister? Weird. Maybe that also caused the breakers. I'm not gonna stay in this dark place, you're just wasting your time. Move on and investigate other places already. Ah, I get it, you're right. Okay, so you're saying that I'm done looking in here. That does cover everything. Okay. Now let's check that bathroom. It's locked. Someone appears to be inside. It's the unisex bathroom. I don't know who's actually in there.
Hey!
Someone in there? Yeah, you're right. Alright. Check the old building.
Hajime.
The old building circuit breaker should be inside this office. Circuit breaker, huh? Might be related to the blackout. But if we check out the circuit breaker first. Yeah. Circuit break first. We don't bring the circuit break. It's like that probably happened because of this.
I see.
Doesn't look like someone did anything to it. Nothing else looks suspicious either. Circuit breaker is pretty high up. Even if you use a stepladder, you won't reach it. Yeah, I totally agree. That's why it's so mysterious. Well, during the backout, I was panicking so bad I forgot about that. But, right, even with the stepladder, there's no way you'd be able to reach that circuit breaker. Which means someone must have reset the breaker after the blackout. But who?
Ta-da!
I did.
Whoa!
What? Why?
Actually,
Yuri had no idea what to do about the blackout, so I'm the only one who reset the circuit breaker.
By the way,
I'm not the one who tripped the breaker. The killer did that, of course. But how did someone as small as you reset the breaker? Well, firstly, my eyes work real good at night, so I have no trouble seeing in the dark. And if you want to know how I reached the circuit breaker, my body stretches. You know, I'm very elastic. Liar! I'm serious. Want to see? Want to see a virgin Monokuma with his body all stretched out? It's gross. It's grotesque. I totally want to see it! Aww.
So
don't you think Monokuma's such a nice guy? It's in a popularity contest, he'd take first place.
I see.
The fuck? So he's the one who reset the breaker. In that case, if we win, there's no way he'd be able to reach that. How'd the killer get there? If they didn't trip it, or said it to be tripped. You! You fucking fuck! Yes! Where were you? Unexpected? Blackout occurred, and during that time, Byakuya was killed. The circuit breaker's in the office. Naturally, it looks suspicious since I was supposed to be here.
Wait!
Supposed to be here, does that mean?
I see.
So I was right, you weren't in the office. But why? Weren't you supposed to guard the circuit breaker and the Duraluminn case with all the weapons in it? Where'd you run off to on your own? Well, that is... Ugh. Yeah, what happened? No, I'm just not feeling too well. I apologize, but excuse me. Excuse me, what was that? Peko, it appears the bathroom inside the old building is currently occupied, so I'd recommend either the hotel lobby or your cottage. Ugh, seems like it'll be a tough path. It's kind of hard for me to say myself. I already feel bad for Peko as it is. What does it mean?
Huh?
I mean, is it cool? She didn't, like, run away or something.
Right.
She ran away. She's obviously the killer. I'm almost positive. Is that really what it is? German case. Getting all the dangerous items from Byakuya collected, alright.
Hey.
Maybe we should check inside just to be safe. But it's locked.
Yep.
Byakuya had the key in the to this particularly turbulent case with him. Check it out. I brought it with me, so there's no need to worry. Hey, is it okay if you use key without permission?
No.
Been to tamper with the crime scene, but if we don't, we can't check inside this case, right? So I should open it. Flick.
See?
It's open. Forks, kitchen knives, iron screws, various tools crammed inside. But it's not impossible. It's not possible that the killer took anything from here. The key to the case was inside the case Bianca had with him. Guess you're right about that. Alright. Thought we had a check.
Camera. I guess we should talk to you.
Maybe.
Hey, isn't Pekka the killer? Why do you think that?
I mean...
Well, she wandered off somewhere even though she was supposed to be in the office. When we were looking for Bianca after the blackout, I went to the office right away, but when I got here, she was gone.
No.
Couldn't say this too loudly, or else Miss Sonia will yell at me. Pekka's probably the one who tripped the circuit breaker and used the blackout to her advantage to kill Bianca. Hey. And don't you think she looks kind of ruthless too? Like an assassin, right? That's not like you look any better. Alright. I believe that's everything I need now. Nope. Guess I have to talk to you. Hey, where'd Pekka go? She looked pretty pale.
Oh.
Hmm. Well, if she made it, then I'm pretty sure she's fine. Beyond that, it'd be improper for me to say. Huh? Oh, what's that? Ah, the AC, though. Maybe that's a thing. Timer is set to 11:30 p.m. Yep.
Now then,
I guess we're done with the office, don't you think so? Yep. Alright.
Yep. Hey.
Guys, check out Byakuya's cottage. There might be something in there. But I'm scared I might encounter some danger if I was there by myself. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Go. To be honest, I don't think you're the killer. Good, because I'm not.
I see.
You sure are strong. You definitely are the chosen one. Chosen by Hope Speak Academy. Yep. Alrighty. And,
hey, what are you doing?
What am I doing, you say? Ha! Now that is truly a foolish question.
We're just checking to see if we can get under the floor from here.
Under the floor? Why?
Who said it was futile? Who decided it was impossible? How did you know I cannot recover my earring?
If it is possible to get under the floor, it'll change our understanding of the murder, I think. So I thought it was important to check it.
You're smart.
I see. See?
Well, think about it.
Hey.
The carpet I laid didn't reach the table where we found the Bianca's body, right? And the dining hall floor had huge gaps between the floorboards. And it's possible that the killer killed Bianca by stabbing him from beneath the floor?
Yep.
That's what I thought, so I'm trying to see if we can get under it from there. Well... I guess it's not possible to get under the floor from outside. The building is surrounded by firm fences, so there's no way to sneak under the floor from here.
But...
Even so, I couldn't find a way to get under the floor from inside the building, either. Is it a possibility that there's a hidden hole somewhere?
Wow.
No, that's not possible. Are you sure? Anyway, right. Seems you can't get under the floor from the outside of the building. That's a relief. Why? Hmm. Get under the floor from the outside of the building, there'd only be one logical suspect. The only person who didn't come to the party and also doesn't have an alibi. Alright, for you, Hiko.
So...
I suspected him too, that's why I was checking to see if it's possible to get on the floor from outside.
Well?
Speaking of which, not long after I began guarding the entrance, Fuyuko came here. Huh? You did?
Huh?
What happened to you, Hiko?
Huh?
Oh, hey. What are you doing here all alone at a place like this?
Yep.
I'm setting guards so Monokuma doesn't come inside.
Huh.
How diligent of you.
Hey.
You're not coming to the party?
What are you saying?
Hell no, not even if you paid me. Parties are stupid, they make me want to puke. Oh. You want to come to the party, right? Isn't that why you came here? Of course not. I was just going for a damn walk. What, do I have to report to you every time I want to go for a fucking walk?
That's wrong.
No, it's not like that, but... Then leave me alone. And then he left. That happened, but why did he come here?
See?
Probably wants to be a part of the group, but he can't be honest about it. He believes he's different from everyone else. That's why he always has to be alone.
Hey.
He's like the main character of an RPG. Have you played this before? Meta as fuck. Good to know.
Even though we don't really know what he's thinking, I don't think we have any reason to doubt him.
I'm glad.
That's a relief. I'm glad. I keep saying you're glad, but we have no idea who the killer is. Well, I guess for now we should stick to the plan and head over to Byakuya's cottage.
As long as the probability is greater than zero, that will suffice! I will most assuredly reclaim the Hellhound earring with my own two hands!
Seems he has no intention of investigating. These are hamsters. Pretty simple. How's it going, man?
Huh?
The hell, didn't I tell you to leave me alone? That's not happening. Didn't you hear Monokuma's announcement? Of course I did. Apparently Byakuya's the one who got killed. So what? What'd you say? Think I'm the killer? Think whatever you want. I'm used to being mistrusted. That's not why I'm... Whatever. Just tell me what you're doing while everyone else is at the party. Checking my alibi, eh? I don't have one. I was just chilling in my college child by myself during that time. The whole time? It's Jackie said she saw you in front of the old building.
Shut up!
Nosy bitch.
Jeez.
It's true, I went for a little walk, and then, just by chance, I ended up passing by the old building. Were you really going for a walk? To tell me you were actually trying to join the party.
Don't fuck with me!
Why the hell would I do that? It's coincidence! It's a coincidence! Alright, got it. Dumbass. Kids these days, man. Kids these days.
Alright!
Now then, we must go over to Byakuya's cottage. Yes, we do. Fat Byakuya. It's locked. Guess we need to ask him for help.
Hey!
Monokuma!
Did you call me?
Yay! Did you call me? Nikito, when did you train Monokuma? Monokuma, I was wondering if you could do us a favor. Something I want to, we want to investigate. Hey, who are you talking to? That's just off my after image. When I get serious, my after image is unleashed. I can even play soccer by myself as long as I have this floating technique. Though it'd be boring to play alone. I have time for this. Just hurry up and open Byakuya's cottage already.
Well,
this is for the class trial. It's something we really need. The class trial? If it's for the class trial, there's no way I can refuse. Now then, there's only one way to spell that can open these doors.
I'll leave the rest to you.
See, I've unlocked the door. Now you can investigate to your heart's content. Why does it open with a magic spell?
Jeez.
It's probably powered by electricity. At any rate, this performance was a waste of time. Now, let's see. We should, you know, go inside then.
Right.
Yep. There's an envelope. It's a letter.
That's weird. Hajime.
Be careful, the first kill will happen tonight. Someone will definitely kill someone. Oh, damn.
This is...
Who would send something like this? Maybe... Hey. Why Byakuya suddenly decided to throw a party. First kill will happen tonight. Someone made this threat to Byakuya. He gathered everyone in one area and was extremely cautious about all dangerous items. He's trying to create a scenario in which everyone can monitor each other. He thought, if he did that, nobody would be able to kill anyone. So he believed this crazy letter. He couldn't ignore the possibility of this happening, even if it was just a worst-case scenario.
Hey.
Remember, what Byakuya kept saying? How he wouldn't let anyone become a victim? He couldn't overlook the slim possibility just to keep his promise? And why did he keep it a secret, if he just told us?
Nope.
He probably couldn't. He probably thought that was also a worst-case scenario. What do you mean? If everyone knew what was in this letter, whether it was a lie or not, everyone have killed, likely begun to doubt each other, and at that point there'd be no turning back. But Byakuya tried to do something about this all by himself without telling anyone.
Yep.
Anyway, whoever sent this is an asshole.
Sorry.
No, this couldn't be a prank, and might also have nothing to do with Byakuya's death at all. Nice.
Hey.
I mean, there's probably not too much time left until the class trial starts, probably. which reminds me, you asked my hero for a favor earlier, right? Yeah, I wanted to find out where everybody was standing just before the blackout. It's probably finished by now. You're coming with me, right?
Sorry,
that's all you. Why? I need some time alone. I'd like to have some time to collect my thoughts. Ah, okay.
Hey.
Also, if you're going back to the old building, you should hear what Mikan has to say as well. I think the results of her autopsy should be done by now. See you later. Indeed. He's pretty pale. I wonder if he's okay. Alright. We will hurry over to the building and continue our investigation next time. I hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. If you like it, leave a comment. And if you want to see more, subscribe. Peace out.